Hello and welcome to this ISOC paper presentation. My name is Erik Hutter from Goethe University in Frankfurt, Germany. The paper I wrote together with Matthias Pacher and Uwe Brinkschulte is titled Evaluation and Complexity Analysis of Task Dependencies in an Artificial Hormone System. Let us dive right in and look at the artificial hormone system we refer to in the title. The artificial hormone system, or AHS, is a middleware to assign tasks to processing elements in a distributed system. As shown in this figure, the individual tasks can use it to communicate as if they were running on a single machine. The AHS is completely decentralized and has no single point of failure. In case a processing element fails, the affected tasks are automatically reassigned on healthy processing elements. Therefore, the AHS can be regarded as self-healing. Task distribution as well as self-healing work by realizing control loops for each task that exchange short messages, called hormones. This figure gives an overview of these control loops. Each processing element has an eager value for each task that represents its suitability for this task. This eager value is broadcast to all other processing elements and compared to the received values. If the send eager value is the highest, the processing element may start executing the task. Once a task has been started, additional hormones are sent. Suppressors are subtracted from the eager values and are used to effectively limit the number of times each task is taken in the system. Accelerators are instead added to the eager values and are used to form clusters of cooperating tasks on neighboring processing elements. The AHS assumes all tasks to be independent. However, for this paper, we wanted to study alternative paths of communication in a set of tasks. This led to the introduction of task dependencies with the notation shown in this figure. If task Tj is running, task Ti must not be executed. This was realized by introducing a new kind of hormones, the negators. If Tj is running, it will send a negator hormone to Ti that stops all instances of Ti and inhibits assigning new instances of this task. If Tj is stopped later on, no negator is sent any longer, and Ti can be instantiated again. This figure shows the modifications done to the AHS's hormone loop. The changes are marked in red. Basically, if negators are received for some tasks, it is stopped immediately and its eager value is forced to zero, preventing new instances from being taken. We already mentioned our goal of realizing alternative communication paths, so let me elaborate on this matter by presenting the setup we used for evaluation of our concept. This is a self-balancing vehicle realized using the AHS. It consists of multiple identical processing elements connected via Ethernet. However, we plan to balance the vehicle using a set of heterogeneous processing elements in the scope of this paper's evaluation. In particular, one processing element capable of running sophisticated tasks to balance the vehicle, and three processing elements that are primarily responsible for reading sensor input values and setting actor output values. However, in case the special purpose processing element fails, the other PEs should be able to replicate its functionality using a collection of multiple simple tasks that are only instantiated when required. This task setup is sketched here. On the left, there is a common input task, and on the right, a common output task. Normally, the special purpose PE executes the four upper tasks, balancing the vehicle. The 14 lower, more general tasks are blocked by negators. Thus, all communication flows through the upper tasks. However, should the special purpose PE fail, the lower tasks are instantiated on the general purpose PEs keeping the vehicle balancing and establishing an alternative communication path from sensor inputs to actual outputs. Should the special purpose PE come back online, the previous communication path is re-established and the general purpose tasks are again blocked by negators. Let's have a look at this setup in action. The video you're about to see shows the setup I just described. Each of the small windows is an AHS instance communicating via Ethernet. The special purpose PE is located in the upper left, and the vehicle behavior is provided by a simulator that behaves exactly like the real vehicle. After starting the system, the vehicle starts to balance using the special purpose processor's tasks. Now, a failure of the special purpose processor is simulated. The other PEs react by immediately assigning the previously blocked general purpose tasks, keeping the vehicle balancing. When resuming the special purpose processor, it immediately takes over control and the general purpose tasks are stopped again. Thus, the vehicle balanced in any scenario, confirming that our implementation works. However, we quickly realized that negators introduce a lot of additional complexity into our task model. Let's consider the following problem. We will assume that each PE has infinite resources and is able to execute any task. Now, given some task set with negator relationships as well as communication patterns amongst them, and two distinguished tasks A and B, the problem is to decide whether a task distribution exists so that no negator relationship is violated and a communication path from A to B exists. Since this problem involves negators and asks for the existence of a communication path, we called it negator path. While this definition may seem complex at first, at its core, it is a rather simple question. We ask whether there is a stable task distribution so that task A can send a message to task B, possibly transformed by multiple intermediate tasks along the way. From this point of view, the practical relevance of this problem follows immediately. If a task set is no negator path instance, then a message sent by task A will never reach its target. This is most probably a design mistake. Thus, for practical applications, some tool is required to warn the system designer of such problems. Looking back at our evaluation scenario, the relevant question is exactly whether the input task on the left can send a message to the output task on the right. This message shall be transformed along the way with the result of balancing the vehicle. As we have seen, this was possible in two different ways. Either a communication path leading through the special purpose tasks or through the general purpose tasks. Thus, it is obvious that our evaluation setup is in fact a negator path instance. Yet, when looking at the general case, two questions arise. On the one hand, we wanted to know whether it is possible to construct setups that are no negator path instances. And on the other hand, warning the designer in such cases requires to efficiently decide the negator path problem. Thus, we wanted to check whether this is possible. A major result of our paper is that negator path is in fact NP complete. Thus, this seemingly simple problem turns out to be very hard, and efficiently deciding it is most likely impossible. In the following, I will show a short example of why negator path is this complex. For the actual proof, please refer to our paper. We will start with this propositional calculus formula F given in conjunctive normal form. In fact, F is a 3-set instance and 3-set is a NP-complete problem. Our goal is to transform this formula into a task set that has a communication path between two distinguished nodes if and only if the formula F is satisfiable. For this reason, we need to encode an interpretation of F using a set of tasks. We thus construct one task for each literal, which makes three tasks per clause as shown here. Our goal is that task X1 is assigned if and only if the interpretation of X1 in the formula is true, and vice versa. The same applies for the other literals. However, for each variable, its literals are mutually exclusive. Thus, we add two negator relationships per variable to ensure exactly one task per variable will be assigned. If negated x1 is assigned, the negators prevent x1 from being assigned, and vice versa. We now introduce two distinguished tasks A and B, as well as one conjunction task. Our goal is to ensure a communication path from A to B exists if and only if the interpretation that corresponds to the assignment of the literal tasks satisfies the formula F. Thus, we express the disjunctions within each clause as alternative communication paths and the conjunction between both clauses as a sequential communication path. This leads to the communication relationships shown here. This actually concludes the construction of our task set, so let's bring it to life. Suppose we interpret all variables x1, x2, and x3 as true. Thus, we assign the tasks x1, x2, and x3. The corresponding negator tasks cannot be assigned because of the negator relationships. Additionally, the tasks A, B, as well as the conjunction task can be assigned because they have no inbound negator relationship. However, no communication path from A to B exists, since F is not satisfied by this interpretation. No task is assigned for its first clause, and no literal of its first clause is satisfied either. Let us thus flip the variable x3 from true to false. Now, task negated x3 is assigned instead of positive x3. This satisfies the formula F, and indeed, there is a communication path from A to B. This explains why a negator path is a hard problem. If F were not satisfiable, no communication path from A to B could ever exist. If we could efficiently decide negator path, we could therefore simply solve three set by transforming it into an appropriate set of tasks and then deciding negator path. Thus, speaking in terms of computational complexity, negator path must be at least as hard as three set. Additionally, in the paper, we have shown that the transformation from three set to negator path can be performed in polynomial time, proving that negator path is actually NP complete. To conclude this talk, let's look at what we have accomplished. We have presented an implementation of task dependencies in the artificial hormone system. This approach worked well in our evaluation scenario. Our vehicle balanced by either a small set of special purpose tasks or a bigger set of more generic tasks. A processing element failure automatically switched the tasks that were active. Additionally, we looked at the complexity that negators introduce into our task model. We have shown that negators introduce a completely new type of mistake that can happen during a system's design. The seemingly simple question whether some task can send a message to another task becomes hard to decide algorithmically. In the future, we plan to conduct research on the negator's impact on the AHS's real-time bounds. Additionally, we want to establish criteria that ensure a stable task assignment, as negators also make it easy to construct oscillating task assignments. Thank you for your attention.